show you how to create a table of contents and list of figures automatically using Word tools. It's really helpful to know how to do this for the formal report, but also just for whatever future things you need to create. So first up, table of contents. The most important thing is that you need to tell Word what you want included in the table of contents. And in order to do that, you mark things as headings. So I'm here in my document, and let's say the first thing I want to include is a list of figures. So I highlight this heading for list of figures and then go to the Home tab, and under Styles, you're gonna select Heading 1. So that automatically formats it for you, and it sort of marks it to be included in the table of contents. So it helps on both counts to get your headings formatted the same, you know, throughout the document, as well as the table of contents. And you can change the styles on this if you don't want the default one. The default is fine for my assignment, but if you want it to look different, you can play around with that. So I had already marked this one, executive summary, as heading 1 as well. And then, oh, I ended up with an extra page in there or somewhere, but that's okay. And then let's say this is the body of the report, so I marked the introduction as a heading. And then the other thing to know about headings is there are different levels. So the highest level, the sort of first level heading, is going to be heading 1, and then subheadings under that could be heading 2 or even heading 3 if you got that far. So let's say I have a research section, and the sort of main heading of that section is research. So I'll just mark that as heading 1. But let's say within the research setting, I have this subheading of primary research. So then I would mark it as 2. So highlight it, go back up to styles, and then find heading 2. It just, you know, formats it for you slightly differently. The hierarchy, it makes it easier for your reader to sort of see the organization of your document. There's different ways to do that. It looks like this is just making the font slightly smaller. So that's completely fine. It's fine to use those. And so you'd probably go through and do this, you know, once the whole document is written, and the sort of table of contents and headings might be one of the last things you do, or you could do it as you write, whatever you want. So then now that I've got some things marked for my table of contents, I go back up to the page that I want to put the table of contents on, which is this page. I click where I want it. Let's say I want it right there. And then you go to References tab. And then you're going to use this table of contents tool and choose whichever one you want. I'm just going to choose this classic one. That's completely fine. And it puts everything in there for you, which is really helpful. And the other helpful thing is that if you change anything, if you move anything around, you can just update the table. So let's say that I decided that I am going to move my research section to the next page. So now it's on page 4 instead of page 3. You can go back to your table of contents. What did I do? Sorry about that. Go back to your table of contents, click on it, and then just do this update table. You can either update just the page numbers or the entire table. Let's just do the entire table. And then it changes the numbers for you. So that's really helpful. The other thing that's going to be helpful is the list of figures. And it's a list of figures is essentially just like the table of contents, except for it gives you the page numbers for your visuals or your figures. Sometimes it's called a list of illustrations too. So in order to get that to work, what you need to do is mark all your visuals or figures, so charts, graphs, pictures, whatever you come up with. You need to give them captions, automatic captions. So to do that, you click on whatever you've got, you right click, and then you just do insert caption. It'll label it like figure 1, 2, 3, and then you can add something to it. So you know, I'm going to say this is a Colorado mountain. You guys can also add a source. So I actually took this picture, so I'm just going to say source Julie Vuk, or if you got it from website, you can put their name, source, wherever you got it from. So that puts it in for you. And then I'm going to do that for my other image. I think I added one basic caption, but again, right click, insert caption. And then this one is already telling me it's figure 2, and I'm going to say Union Station, Denver, for that one. So you would do that again for all the visuals in the assignment, and then go back to your list of figures page, which is going to be right after the table of contents. And same thing, put your cursor where you want it to be. It's also under the references tab, and it's this insert table of figures. So I'm just gonna choose like this classic one and say okay, and it gives you the figure, the caption you wrote with it and the page number it's on. This one, it seems like it doesn't default to putting a title on it, so you can just say list of figures or list of illustrations. So let me know if you have any questions. Thanks.